Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creative Process. In this tutorial, we'll be creating out this graphic design. We'll be creating a spade playing card using Illustrator and Photoshop. The final output will be like this. We'll be talking about the standard dimension of a playing card and look at how you can add a pattern to your card designs. Like over here, we have added a pattern inside a spade and giving it a nice unique look to the card, so you can create out your own versions of card using this technique. So let's begin with the designing process. So to design this, we'll first create out a spade using the ellipse tool. We'll use rectangle tool to create out the background, add these nice shadows and depth. So let's begin with the designing process. So for this, first we're gonna do is to go to Illustrator and open a new Illustrator document. Now to create a card, we need to use the dimensions. So I select the rectangle tool and click over here. The width and height are in inches. For that, if your dimensions are not in inches, you can just go to Illustrator Preferences, General, and over here go to Unit. And under general, just select inches. By default, it might be points or pixels, but you have to select inches to get the dimension and then click OK. Now, if I click over here, you can set the width and height in inches. So I'll set the width to 2.5 and the height to 3.5 inches. This is our standard dimension. There are two standard sizes for playing cards. For polo cards, the size measures 2.5 by 3.5 inches, and for bridge size cards, the sizes ranges from 2.25 to 3.5 inches. So for this, we are using the polo size card. So let's work on this. Now you can see the corner points are pointed, so let's make it rounder using these circular icon. Just click and drag to create the circular to give that curve, nice curve to all the four corners. Now let's add a background so that we can see what effects we're giving. So I'll draw a rectangle for the background and fill it up with something different colors. So and arrange it to back. First of all, let's change the stroke color. So I will give a gradient color to the stroke thickness. So I'll select this and go there and select the gradient color. And now over here, select the stroke color and double click on the gradient tool to open the gradient editor panel. And over here, let's change this color to something else. So let's choose something bluish maybe, and let's add a little greenish tone maybe, and let's fade it out. You can see that over here. Let's zoom it in and we can make it a little fader. So I'll go to HSP and here let's fade out the color a little bit, and here we go. Now let's set the thickness. So before that, let's increase the thickness and let's see what are we doing here. So over here you can adjust the direction of your gradient stroke color. So we'll keep the darker shades on the right side and the lighter on the left side. So now let's change the thickness. So let's add 2.5 and then done. So here we go, we have added the thickness. So we'll be creating this spade design. To create that, I'll go to ellipse tool and draw the ellipse over here. Let's fill this up with black color and we'll use the anchor point tool and break these corners. So first let's click over here and we'll break it. We had to set the handles. Let me change the background color to a little lighter tone. So I'll choose some lighter color. Now let's see how it looks like. So with the anchor point tool, I'll select this and break this handle like that. Do the same over here. We'll make sure that we are breaking the handles like that. And now after that, using the die selection tool, let's adjust this handle. We'll make a little curve and drag it down like this, and this one drag it up, and with this handle we'll give this nice curve shape over here. Let's adjust it properly so that we get this nice curve over here. Once you're done, let's select the rectangle tool and From the middle, let's draw a rectangle like this and we'll subtract it out. So selecting both these shapes, go to Pathfinder and subtract the top surface from the low one. Now we got this. Let's do some little more adjustments with this. So we'll be using the direct selection tool and keep on adjusting it. Now we'll create a duplicate, like a mirror design of this, so that we can create the other side. So to create that, select the shape and go to reflect tool. Set the points at this path and with the alt press click and drag, and with the shift press save it. So we got this. Let's remove the stroke color. After this, combine them together and we got a nice shape. Now we need the lower part as well, so I'll use the rectangle tool and from here draw a rectangle like this. With the alt pressed, I'm making this rectangle. If I leave the alt press, you can see it's making from this corner, but with the alt press you can make the rectangle from the center. Now I'll do like this, and with the direct selection tool, select these two corners. Let's drag it down like this, and we'll be using this free transform tool and select this third one, perspective distort, click and just drag it in, and it will make the both the corner points come closer to each other without affecting the other corners. So, and after that, select the direct selection tool, and for here we need some handles. So to activate the handles, I need the help of anchor point tool, and just click and drag like this. After that, break this anchor point so that it doesn't give that curve extension. In the same way, right there over here also, and just make it better over here. Now after this, just work with the handles like this. Now for the lower one, we need to, let's say, expand, let's make it a little bigger, use the handles to give this curvish effect over here. So we have given that nice look to the lower design as well. Now selecting both, we got the spade shape. We can use this for further design. Let's create a duplicate of it with the alt pressed, and I'll just combine them together. Now the next step is to, let's say, let's add up these sticks first so that we can work on the other stuff later on. Now we'll create a duplicate over here, but the opposite. So we'll do that using this rotate tool. I'll set the center point to center of the card, and with the alt press just click and drag, and with the shift press you can just snap it like this. If I leave the shift, you can see it's rotating in a smooth way, but if I press shift, it snap it. Our main part of the tutorial is to creating this pattern design. So to create out this, let's combine them together. Let's make it a little broader like this, so they got that broader look. Now I'll just create a duplicate, command or control C to copy, and command control F to paste in front. And now over here we'll remove these lower extensions. So with the pen tool, I'll just delete out these anchor points, and with the direct selection tool we'll make it smoother like this, so that we don't get that ununiform shape there. We need a smooth curve finishing over here. Now let's fill this up with a bright color. So I'll choose white color and give a stroke color of black, and let's increase the stroke thickness. Before that, let's go to stroke and change it to align stroke to inside. This way stroke will be inside our design. So now let's increase the thickness, so 3.5, let's see. So I think 3.5 is perfect size for this. So after this, I will select this and go to object path outline stroke, so that we can convert into fill path and ungroup them. So the next step is to create that pattern design. So I will make sure that we have this reference over here so that we can make it properly. We'll be using the pen tool to create out this design. So select the pen tool, choose the fill color to black, so that you can we can get this look directly. So now click and just follow along the curve path. Now with the die selection tool, I make sure that all the things are properly aligned and properly shaped. So we have to do some tweaking at this step so that you got a perfect shape. And for this section, let's draw the shape. So keep on doing it until you are finally fully satisfied with that. And let's add a small circle at this corner. So select the ellipse tool and draw a circle like that over here. I think we have done all the tweaking part very perfectly. Now let's select the rectangle tool, and I'll just delete out the extra extended shapes. So let's draw out a rectangle from the center and like that. And selecting these two shapes, subtract out the extra shapes. Now we'll select these pieces, remove the stroke color, and make a duplicate. So we'll use the rotate tool, maybe mirror. We need the mirror shape. So reflect tool, click at this corner, at this edge corner, and with the alt press, click and drag. And you can create a duplicate like that. Let's select these and these and these, and I just combine them, maybe this and this, combine them and this, combine them, got a white. So I'll select these and group them up, command G or control G, then place it at your design, and let's set the size accordingly. So this is our previous design we have created, and this is right now we have created. I'll open a new Photoshop document, set the width and height to 2000 by 1200 pixel. And for the background, we're gonna use greenish blue color, and for that we'll be using this color code. So let's select this blue, and here is the color code 4CC080. So I'll just copy these and over here paste it and alt backspace. So we got the color in the background. Now let's drag and drop our design from the Illustrator. So first I'll select this background, only the background part, and drag and drop it to Photoshop. Then Illustrator, go to Illustrator, I'll select only the text parts and the pattern design and place it there. And now select both the smart objects, command control D, scale up the size. Now to add this realistic drop shadow effect and nice glow over here like that, for that I'll just select the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle on the base like here. So we'll just draw the rectangle like this over the base, fill it up with black color. Here is the color black, and with the die selection tool we'll just do some adjustments. So select these and make it like that, just from here also make sure it's placed like that. And we'll be using the convert point tool. So under Photoshop, it's convert point tool. We'll use this to make this curve finishing over here. Do the same for the other direction as well. So select that and make it curvish like that. Now convert this rectangle into smart object and go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and we'll add a nice blur effect to this. So give 2.4 or 2.5 and let's drag it down a little bit like that. And over here at the edges you can see some shades are coming out, so we need to do the adjustments, command or control T, and with the select the wrap option, and let's just make sure that they are inside over here like that, make a little inward so that we got that nice zoom occlusion. Do the same for the other side as well. We'll just make sure that they are a little bit corners a little bit inward like that. So we got that drop shadow at the edge. We'll now create the drop shadow. So select the pan tool and draw the shape. Let's tweak it a little bit more. So and after this, add a new layer, and create a make selection. Okay, and fill it up with black color. Come on, now Control D. Then after that, we'll do smart object and we'll add tilt shift. So for that, go to filter, blur gallery, tilt shift. And here you can set the direction of the blur effect. So I'll just set the direction like this, and I'll just drag and drag in to adjust the blur distance and increase the blur value over here to give that nice blur effect. And at the nearer one, we got a sharp blur, and at this we got faded blur, so we can give the nice draw fall effect. After this, I will reduce the opacity around 31 like that, and to give more realistic effect, I'll add a mask, and selecting gradient tool with the black and white color selected, we'll just drag and apply gradient like that. So if you see, if I apply opposite way, you can see the darker shades are over here. So we'll click and drag upward to give that soft fade like that. So let's keep on doing it. And if you feel like you need to do more adjustments, just click on this and remove the lock part, and selecting this gradient layer, just drag and drag it up until you get that effect which you want. So I think this one is better. Lock it up. Now I'll be adding this light effect. We got this light white source. So for that, I'll select the circle tool, or maybe any shape you like. So I'll be using ellipse tool and draw an ellipse like this. For that, fill it up with white color, and after that I'll convert this into smart object, and then I'll place it below all the this shadows, and go to filter, blur, for the first motion blur, and give a motion blur like this. And after that, go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, give a soft like that, and we'll adjust the opacity. So adjust the opacity around 40 and set the angle of rotation, so we'll make it a little bit of tilted angle and place it like that. And let's change the blend mode to screen, and for all the shadow layer as well. So selecting that, multiply, select this layer, multiply, and if you check it out, we got this nice shadow over here. And let's add a text so that we can give. So this is SPAD spade, and let's fill this up with white color. And after that, let's scale on the size and place it in the center. So overall, we have created spade playing card design with a nice pattern to it. So during the process, we have seen how you can create a spade design using very simple techniques, like using these basic shapes and creating out the design. Then after that, we have drawn out this pattern using the pen tool, but for that you have to make sure that you have the exact pattern you want to add to your design, and then shift to Illustrator and create it out. Then the next thing is, we have seen how you can create this cover design. Like, we have added this nice composition in Photoshop, and for that, we to give the nice look, we have added some drop shadow and a falling shadow as well. As and at this corner, we have that nice lighting that shows there's a multiple light in front, so this is giving a nice cool effect to your design. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to this channel. Thank you.